Dr. NGR Educational and Research Institute, University, Madurai, Chennai. Dr. NGR Educational and Research Institute, University, Madurai, Chennai.
A very warm welcome to one and all present here for the 3 days of National E-Workshop. Fashion you can buy, but style you possess. The key to style is learning who you are, which takes years. There is no how to roadmap to style. It's about self-expression and about all attitudes. by Iris Apfel. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's workshop. I'm Ms. Nandini Kuti, teaching assistant at Dr. MGR Educational and Research Institute. Dr. MGR Educational and Research Institute is one of the leading institutions in Tamil Nadu. It's indeed a great honor for me to host today's program. Today's workshop is on the topic New Era Art Workshop. And today's topic is presented by Mrs. Jayashree Narayanan, Fevicryl Certified Specialist. Now, I welcome upon Mrs. M. Mahmuda Begum, Head of the Fashion Design Department, to deliver the welcome address.
Thank you, Ms. Nandini. A very good afternoon to one and all present here. According to the great words uttered by Brain Herbert, the capacity to learn is a gift. The ability to learn is a skill. The willingness to learn is a choice. Having said this, I take immense pleasure to perform the duty of welcoming the gathering. On behalf of Fashion Design Department, I would like to render a warm welcome to our Founder Chancellor, ACS Shanmugam, and our beloved President, Engineer ACS Arun Kumar, for their motivation and support given to conduct this program. I cordially welcome our Vice President, Dr. M.K. Padmanabhan, for his encouragement. I'm really privileged in welcoming our Vice Chancellor, Dr. S. Geeta Lakshmi, for gracing her presence. She is a woman of distinct vision of knowledge and experience. She motivates us by sharing her innovative ideas for the welfare of her university. She has received the Best Teacher Award from Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University and Tamil Nadu Medical Council. She was honored by the Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu for the rescue operations of Mugaliwakkam building collapse. She has also received the Lifetime Achievements Awards. She has been the pillar of support and motivation. Ma'am, you are really an inspiration to all of us. I feel proud in welcoming you, ma'am. I wholeheartedly welcome our eminent Pro-Vice Chancellor, Dr. Ravichandran, our Provost, Dr. G. Gopalakrishnan, and our Registrar, Dr. C. B. Palanivelu, for their support. It gives me immense pleasure in welcoming Dr. Mali Pandey, our Joint Registrar, HNS, on behalf of Fashion Design Department, Adiyalampattu Campus. We welcome you all. I also extend my heartfelt gratitude to our Joint Registrar, Dr. S. Ramalingam, our Dean S. Manivannan, and Deputy Dean Dr. V. N. Rajavarman, for making the pillars of support. I would like to welcome Mr. Nadim, Director, Institute of Design, and all the heads and staff members of our institute. We have come to this program to have a really excellent thing. The resource person for today's program is Mrs. Jayashree Narayanan, who is an expertise and has a lot of experience in this field. She was one of the panelists for judging art competition conducted by Rotary Club to enter the Guinness Book of Records. I feel honored in welcoming you, ma'am. I also welcome our beloved participants who have registered for our workshop to learn and gain knowledge. I'm sure that you will feel enriched with knowledge after completion of this program. My dear participants, the feedback link will be provided on the last day of the workshop, which is on 12th August. You can post your queries in the chat box if you have any clarification at the end of the session. I welcome you all once again to this workshop and hope that you will have a great time ahead. Thank you, one and all.
It was indeed a very pleasing addressing given by you, ma'am. Now I welcome upon Dr. S. Geeta Lakshmi, Vice Chancellor of Dr. MGR Educational Research Institute, to deliver the inaugural address.
A very good good evening. Am I audible? Just a minute. Am I audible? Hello.
Yes, ma'am. You're audible.
Yeah. So a very good evening. And today being a lot of programs were there for me. I was just hopping out from one meeting to another. So I was waiting for you. And the next meeting is with the Ramesh Dean. So it's a very really nice to be with you all. To tell you, I love this kind of fashion design or whatever it is. Apart from my medical field, I would like to learn from the other field. What are the works going on, and what of help can I be to them? So this is how my thoughts would go. And today, being that you have brought me into this field, I would also be listening to what's being done in your field. So thanks for inviting me for the inaugural program. And I thank our management, Mr. A.C. Shanmugam, chairman and founder chancellor of this university, and Mr. Arun Kumar, who have been a motivating force and running of this great institution, Dr. MGR deemed University Educational Research Institute, with a lot of other programs and education going on in different branches. As you know, like today, I mean, yesterday we had 8.83 crores of fund sanctioned to our university for skill development for rural people, particularly the young men and women, to develop skill on various fields for about 36 months of training in our university under various categories. So this would make them be going to the field and getting their skill developed, and they can have their own entrepreneurship or can go for their own work or develop their own kind of factory or whatever it is. And this is how the government of Tamil Nadu has given this fund for the university. And really, they have they have known that this university can do a lot better than any other university. So that's how they have identified. So I should thank the government of Tamil Nadu and the there are two people who are being given this in charge, and they would do their best to develop the rural boys and girls to develop their skills for training them for 36 months. So I should inform you this. And I also thank the fashion designing department, which they introduced themselves a few minutes ago. But still, it takes some time for me to remember them, because the more I get in touch with them, the more I start to remember them. So since it's the first time, I would like to know about them more and more. And since fashion designing is the talk of the day, like I see in everything from arts to anything for that matter, today morning also I was, because in Google also or in Apple also, you have some design for them to be identified. So in that kind, you can have the designs made done, not only for fashion as well as other designing. As you saw, I saw some toys and other things, but I still, there are more innovation in this field. And of course, I know that the department gives them some practical knowledge and training, because it's a skill. So you have to do your, really get into the work rather than into the theory. Theory we can hear and we can assemble our knowledge, but to do it practically is very difficult. So I think like the department does the skill development and getting themselves attached into various institutions which develop these skills. So it's one of the best institutions today to have this fashion designing. And I think so this fashion designing course will make people develop their own enterprises for development of, it's like sitting at home and doing something, some work, or you can go to the bigger institutions to show your skills. So this is how it can be developed from a smaller to a bigger institution. So this would be give contentment to people who want their arts art to develop. There are, I think so, like me, like who go for education. There are people who want their art development. They have their art in their hand, but we do not identify these children. So it is our responsibility also here to go to each and every institution and give them the awareness that these are the and the fashion designing is here, and this is how you can develop your skill. Definitely there would be a lot of them to develop. They have their inert skill, which has to be brought out by us. So I want the faculty members to go over to institution to bring out their skills by giving them some program and giving them some awards or prizes so that you can identify these children during their plus one. And this education policy also has made it easy in the coming years, which would be rolled out. So your fashion designing department will have a greener pasture in future. Thank you, one and all, for giving me this opportunity today. And I thank Manivanan, the dean and the deputy dean, registrars. And there are so many names which I couldn't remember. But of course, I will all remember you all. The more you come and meet me or come in communication with me, definitely I will make myself available to you and help you in whatever venture you want to help. You need my help. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, ma'am. It was a very energetic speech given by you, ma'am. We are very much blessed for having you on this event. Now I welcome upon Dr. Manivanan, Dean of Faculty of Humanities and Science, Dr. MGR Educational Research Institute, Phase 2, to deliver the facilitation address.
Good evening, everyone. It gives me immense pleasure in appearing before you all and delivering felicitation address. First of all, I wanted to thank our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Geeta Lakshmi Madam, for joining with us. Thank you, Madam. It's a really great day for all of our MGRians to get to know about 8.8 crores, which is not a simple amount and which is a huge amount and the first success story being penned under your leadership. Great, Madam. This shows that we will go beyond this level also. 10 crores also we will cross, something like that. It is coming to my mind. It's a great day for all of our MGRians. And with this positive note, let me move to the felicitation address. And of course, today I'm happy to see the fashion design department of our Dr. MGR University is coming forward in organizing this 3 days workshop. I can say straight away workshop in terms of preserving the traditional Indian art with the help of the chief guest, Mrs. Jayasri Narayanan. She is such a able person and bringing the a traditional art like Tholu Bommalata, in Tamil Thol Bommalatam, which has its origin from Andhra Pradesh, and of course dress mural of Kerala. Of course, the third one is our own tradition, Tanjore style fusion, Tanjore painting. So all these things will be covered by this fashion design workshop in each and every day, one topic, something like that they have planned. Really, it's an amazing moment for all of our student community to understand the concept of going for the traditional art. And of course, when I was interacting with Jayasri Madam, she is with great lot of ideas, especially when she's talking about the Tanjore painting. Instead of going for costlier Tanjore painting, she has suggested some method to go for cost-effective solution also. So this will in turn bring a lot of buying potential for the middle class family also, such that everybody will be going for purchase of this kind. Plus, of course, the other traditional arts like Bommalatam, which we could see only in movies. But now I'm happy to see that our university has taken initiative in doing this kind of workshop here itself. Of course, I wanted to see few of our students doing this kind of Ramayanam or Mahabharatam, something like that in our next college event also in real-time function, say for example, conventional something departmental event where few of our students coming forward with the help of this today's workshop and doing activity for our department. It's a wonderful day for my life and I'm really happy to see that that one. Of course, I wanted to congratulate head of the department, Mrs. Mehmooda Begum, for doing this kind of wonderful initiative along with her department staff like Ms. Kalevani, who is doing a technical work, really a great thing. And of course, I wanted to congratulate Ms. Nandini Kutty for doing this kind of wonderful job. Let me convey my best wishes and do very good for your next event also. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for such a wonderful facilitation given by you. Now, I would like to introduce about our chief guest who will be taking session for the next couple of days. Today's chief guest is Jayashree Narayanan, Fevicryl Certified Specialist. Mrs. Jayashree Narayanan graduated from Stella Maris College, Chennai. She is Fevicryl Specialist for more than 30 years. She is Vice President of Kalamilan Fevicryl Hobby Teachers Club at Chennai. She has won the FACE Award, first prize, in 2007 at state level. She has been awarded the Best Performance Award from the years 2007 to 2011. She conducts summer camps, workshops for kids for all age groups. She has helped in organizing mega events to enter Limca Book of Records with students of Bhavan Rajaji Vidyashram School, Daniel Thomas Matriculation School, St. Britos Velamal School, Prince Sri Venkateshwara College, Gateway, the complete school, and nearly 11 events has been recorded. She has conducted a mega event of Rakhi making for the Jawans of CPR of Chennai with the participation of 2,000 students of Jain School in Chennai. We welcome you, ma'am.
A very happy good afternoon to one and all. This is Jayashree Narayanan, Fevicryl Certified Specialist from Chennai. On the outset, let me thank Sri Dr. A.C. Shanmugam, the Founder Chancellor, Sri Engineer A.C.S. Arun Kumar, the President, Dr. Geeta Lakshmi, Vice Chancellor, the Deans, the Heads, staff members, and the management for giving me this wonderful opportunity to get along with you these 3 days. And I'll be sharing the procedure of making a Tulu Bommalata style of painting. And then the second day, it is going to be a dress mural from Kerala. And the third day, of course, from our Tamil Nadu, the Tanjore style of fusion painting. Okay, and then I would, my special thanks to Mamuda Begum, the HOD of Fashion Design Department. Now, before we start, let me first tell you these 3 days, please do attend carefully and then get benefited. I'm sure all the students were informed well in advance with the materials, what are all required for the session. And I think you are all ready with that also. And then the topics which we are going to cover in these 3 days would be Tolu Bommalata, that is for today from Andhra. So from one state to another state, we will be moving on. So today it is Andhra and tomorrow it will be Kerala. And day after tomorrow, of course, it is our Tamil Nadu. Okay, what is Tolu Bommalata? Tolu means the outer skin, okay, the leather. And then Bommalata is the puppet dance. So combining these two on the leather, people used to make the puppet and then they enact the stories of epics of Ramayana and Mahabharata, especially during the night time in the villages, telling the people the story of those two epics also. So they tie the strings, stand behind the screen, and then they pull the string, enacting the entire story, and thereby the people understanding it very easily. So now let's get started. We will start the session with the painting. Now, one second. Before we start the actual painting, I would like to teach you some of the important the motives and other things which are carried out during the painting of the Tolu Bommalata. This is normally done on leather, but since the slaughter of animals are banned, people nowadays do it on synthetic leather with the synthetic colors. Now let's begin with the sketching of few patterns. Now to begin with, I will teach you how to draw the leaves. The leaves which they normally do for this kind of painting are two in numbers. One will be on the stalk of the leaves. The leaf will be somewhat oblong in shape like this. A very simple one, because these are all traditional Indian art form. So they don't have much knowledge of drawing it in a very perfect way. So these kind of drawings are carried out. This is one kind of a leaf which they normally follow. You could find all these works in the available in the market, the lampshades and other pieces. Initially, this was done on the leather to make only the puppets, and off late people started doing it, making it commercialized, like they make lampshades, then they make wall hangings, and then different kinds of accessories also they do. I would like to share all those things towards the end of the session once we finish the painting. Now, the next kind of leaf would be like a regular one, how we normally paint. That is the regular shape of a leaf like this. And then the center midrib, of course. Then the side veins, they do. These are the two kinds of characteristic leaves, which the patterns which they follow in the Tholu Bommalatta style. This is the one. Okay, now we move on to the floral pattern. They have the flora and the fauna in the work, and also the other important thing is the border for the entire work. So these three things they compose and then they paint on the leather. Now for the flora and the fauna, for the flowers, once again, certain flowers are characteristic for this kind of painting. So one would be like they have a small circle in the center, then another one following it, then they have this kind of curves. This is the most important thing which they follow, these curves. These are sometimes used to fill up the gaps on the pieces, the base which they do. So this curves is a characteristic pattern of Tholu Bommalatta. Then according to the size of the base on which they do, they enlarge, that is they compose it in a bigger way. So like this is the center of the flower, following it is the petals arranged. Once again, an arch in shape here, following the flower to complete the flower like this. Then around the flower, they have the leaves, which I told you just now, the regular one, which we do. This kind of leaf is, the leaves are placed around the flower. So like this, you start at one point, then you continue the leaves covering the outer surface of the flower, making the design little bigger. This is the one. Okay. And then we move on to the next kind of leaf. This is also another important thing and very, very interesting one, which you could find whether it is a lampshade or on a wall panel or any other matter for that matter done on the leather. This kind of flower, which I'm going to show you right now, is very most important and a interesting one also. They have the stalk of the flower like this, and then they close the end like this, a small curve. Then after these two, after drawing the stalk and these two, the semicircles, they compose the flower. I'll just show you. The flower composing will be, once again, I told you the curved lines. So this curved line first, and then they expand the length and the breadth of the petal once again. Then again, little bigger in size, and slowly they reduce the size, and then form a full bloomed flower like this. This is how it will be. Okay. Then another one, the next one would be, once again, the same kind of the stalk for the flower. They close the end like this. These are some of the characteristic features in drawing the pattern of the flower or the leaves for the Tholu Bommalatta style. Then here also, once again, they make a small circle like this, then another one. Then, as I told you earlier, the curves pattern. Then here on top of this, at the top, they form a lotus flower. Like this. Next time when you happen to see any Tholu style of painting in the market, just have a look at it. These things will be the exact the same thing what I'm sharing right now with you. And then these, for these two flowers, the leaves will be just an oblong shaped at the sides, because the coloring for these leaves are a little different, and for the earlier one which I shared, that is also a different kind of coloring. So this will be a different kind of coloring, and the second one is also a different one. Then I'll show you some of the other patterns which I have already ready with. Now just see, this is I shared with you a full flower to fill up the border or to fill up the gaps here and there on the surface. They have the half flower like this. Just draw a straight line and then continue the same pattern which I taught you, which I showed you right now. This is how the flower will be, half flower. And then you have the full flower, the drooping flower I told you. The same way, you start over here, then slowly you expand the size of the petal and then reduce the size and bringing it to a small one at the tip. These are all the petals arranged in rows. Then the next one, the flower which I shared, this is the one. And here is the lotus flower, and this is a small one with the like the petals are like the leaves only, little lengthier in size. Okay, and then I told you border is most important for the entire work, whether they do a lampshade or a wall panel or for the any other article. The border is a must. These are some of the samples of the borders which are carried out on the painting. Very, very simple. And moreover, when you look closely into all these patterns which I have shared right now, they have a close resemblance to three other Indian art forms. They are the Pattachitra, the Madhubani, and then the Kalamkari. Kalamkari, of course, we all know it belongs to Andhra. And Pattachitra and the other Madhubani. For Madhubani, we have birds. So that bird is also used here in Tholu Bommalata. This is a kind of bird which you see in Madhubani art also. So the same thing they carry out in Tholu also. And border, of course, for Madhubani also, a border is a must. And here for Tholu also, border is a must. So they have a close resemblance with all the three things. They don't have an exact origin of its own, but they just pick and choose from all these three, and then they compose the form. That was, this is the original traditional art form. So they don't have any knowledge of how to draw a leaf or anything like that. So they copied. They must have copied, I think. So all these things were composed and formed the Tholu style of painting. This is the, I told you, this this one. Apart from that, this kind of elephant is another characteristic design of Tholu Bommalata. Okay. So this also, they do like wall hanging or a puppet with a string at the back attached. And then they enact the story during the night time, only at the villages to begin with in earlier days. And then, of course, off late, I told you, they made it very commercialized. So for that, they have patterns like this for the pendant jewelry. These are some of the pendant jewelry patterns. I'll be showing the finished articles also. So now let's move on to the actual work. So for that, I told you, the materials are a canvas sheet. It is a 16 by 20 size, which was mentioned to you in the poster. So you take a canvas sheet. 16 by, and another thing, this is the fish, the design which was shared to you. This fish you find normally in Madhubani style of painting. So this also has a close resemblance to Tholu Bommalata style of painting. Okay. Now take the circle, take a circle of 16 inches in size, the diameter, cut it into two. We need only half of it, half the circle, to convert it into a lampshade. So now after cutting it, I've just cut the paper, the canvas sheet, into half only. Now we are going to compose the pattern in this. I want to fix up this fish over here. So what I would do is I will just fold it and make a mark in the center so that the fishes facing on each side, right and left, will be equally placed on the sheet which on which we are going to paint. So we will mark the center. Now this is the center point of the sheet. Now you have to place the fish on one side like this and the same the mirror image on the other side. That is how you have to compose. If you have only this, then you can take the mirror image of this and place it over here. And then the leaves and the flowers and other fillings, what you do over here, the same thing has to be carried out on the other side. Now we will start with this. Now how do we trace the design? We have the pattern, the line drawing, of course the design. Now I'll teach you a simple technique, a tip for tracing the pattern. On the back side, you can attach, you can paste a black carbon. Okay, so that you can place it exactly over there wherever you want to and then you can trace it up. Suppose if you are using a black carbon, a full sheet, and if you place it on that, you might smudge and you might even dirty the other places also. Just to avoid that, please make a printout like this, that is the design on top and the carbon paper at the back. Now it is easier for us to place it here and then get it traced. Now I would like to place the fish like this. This is the exact the center point. Now using a pen, I would trace out the design. Okay, give a nice press and then you trace it out. The full design you have to trace it. Whatever you see. So this full sheet, already I have shared the full design, but here I am just teaching you how to place the design on the carbon, I mean on the canvas sheet, and then tracing it out step by step. Suppose if this is the A3 size paper, you can take two A4 size Xerox, place it on either side, and then you can take it. Please check it out whether the design falls at the bottom also. Those who have the materials, please do take it out and do a piece along with me. This is a wonderful platform nowadays, especially in this pandemic situation. And now that we are going to learn three different art forms of India, for the first day, this is the Tolu Bommalatta style of painting. The second day, of course, you are going to design your own dress using the Kerala mural style of painting. And the final day, it is going to be a Tanjore style of fusion art. So now that we have finished one side, now the design is transferred fully onto the canvas sheet. Hope you are able to see this. Okay. Now using a pencil or using the design which I have shared already, you can just trace it on the canvas sheet. Now here I'm not going to trace it. I will just teach you how to compose the pattern. Now that the fish is drawn on one side, one half I will do. Same way you have to do the other half. Now here, from the mouth of the fish, I would like to have the flower drooping off like this. So let me draw a line from the mouth. Just watch me doing it. This is how I drew it on the paper. And then a small curve over here, another one. Now slowly you form the petals of the flowers. Small curves like this. Slowly you expand the length. Like this. Okay. Can you all see this? It's a little lighter, but next step you would find you would be able to see it properly. Now For I told you, border is a must for this. Whatever you do, whether it is a lampshade or a wall panel, I repeat, a border is a must. So now we have marked the semicircle on the canvas sheet. Now the border should be carried out. So the border has some patterns, which I showed you a few designs. See here. These are some of the simplest, but the original which they do on the Tholu style of painting. So I'm going to take any one of these and carry it on the canvas. Now here, start from the center, the midpoint. Okay. Now we can mark one more line also here. Another curve parallel to the earlier curve. This is a semicircular piece of canvas. We are going to convert it into a lampshade. So now here we will draw the design. Now from start from the center midpoint, arching shaped, then followed by that at the side, just the petal of a flower like. Those who are free at, very good at freehand drawing, you can continue the pattern. The others, you may trace it out using an yellow carbon or a black carbon. Both are recommended. You can use both. But in original, those people, they don't use any carbon sheet. This, it comes generation after generation. So what they do is they freehandedly draw everything first, either with a pencil or directly with the paint and the brush. So it depends upon the person, how experienced he is. So now we have drawn the border at one side. Okay. Now I'm going to continue a flower in the center. Once again, I start from the midpoint of the whole, the entire sheet. This is the center. Draw a small circle and make it a little darker for you to see. Then another line. Then I told you it is the curves which they follow. This is actually, this is how they do. First two small circular lines followed by the curves and then the flower, then the leaf. Then another line above that. Then we have the flower. Once again, the petals of the flower start from the center and then you continue at the both the sides. So this is one. Okay. Then above this, they will compose the leaves. So once again, leaf. Here comes the leaf, which I showed you, a normal one around the flower. Now we have, let us have another pattern over here. See, now we have the fish, we have the flower, then we have another half flower at the bottom, then we have the border also for this piece. Now we will have another kind of flower in the center alone, because these designs are to be carried out on the other side. Now for the, exactly in the center, I'll just show you a branch drooping out with the leaves, the first kind of leaves. So draw a straight line, then another one parallel to it. Now you can add the leaves to it. The oblong shape, leaves on either side. So this is how the pattern would be. And here and there, filling off the gaps. Here and there, for filling of the gaps, you can add some flowers, like a small circle, then around that another small circle, but that's it, leave it off. Then at some places, you can have a circle, another circle, and then the curves around it. So this is how they do. Now that we have done the composing of the pattern on one side, so you people can do the same thing on the other side also. Now, the next step, what we are going to move with is the outlining of the entire picture. So for that, normally when we do any painting, we do the coloring and then finally we give a black outline to enhance it, keeping doors, this and that. But here, on the other hand, for Tholu Bommalatta style, it is not so. Once you draw the pattern, the next step should be the outline of the entire picture. Whatever you have drawn, you need to outline it with the black color. So here being the canvas base, we are going to use black acrylic. Okay, now let us transfer black acrylic onto the palette and then we'll start outlining the work. Such an interesting art form. How many of you are doing? You can just message in the chat box also. I'll be so happy. Now here we'll take a round brush, preferably size number 3. Okay. Now 1:1 ratio of water you can add to the paint for the easy flow on the surface. So mix it nicely. Keep it ready. I need some more paint. Just a drop will do. Then you load the brush. Whatever I have drawn, everything should be outlined with black. So let's start from the top to make it easier so that we do not mess up the work. Now, just hold the brush like this, draw the outline. Please do stay tuned till the end and the other 2 days also. Such lovely, interesting art forms we are going to share with you all. Okay, now we move on to the fish. The fish is once again a typical Madhubani pattern. And even in Kalamkari also you have. Hope all of you are able to see. Then fill up the eyeball also, the eyebrow. And one more thing, these lines, the black lines, should be very, very bold and prominent. Should be very, very clear. No thin lines. It should be thick enough. So make sure the lines are very bold and thick and dark. No diluting the colors much. And you enjoy doing it. A lovely art form. Here I have just marked a single line, but I would like to go with this kind of pattern. So let me do like this. Okay. Then the center portion. You should give little drying time for this and then we can start with the coloring. Say about 15 to 20 minutes, that's more than enough. The fins. seems also once again these curves are carried out. And then you can add few lines also. Then this flower. From the mouth of the fish, the flower comes out. See the curves, a characteristic design of Tholu. See, now when you see the picture, after coloring it with black, I could see the pencil marks in it. So what I would do is, I will wait for it to dry completely and then erase it off with an eraser. Okay, all the pencil marks are seen. So after drying, you can erase it off. It goes. Now here, the down portion, the half flower. Then comes the petals of the flower. Just see the thickness of the lines, how bold they are. This is how they do on the leather also, using the translucent colors. And now comes the leaves. Now for the leaves, the detailed work, say for example, the midrib, the veins, everything should be drawn beforehand, not after coloring it. Each and every detailed work should be carried out beforehand. Now here the center midrib, and then you have the side veins, all done with black. Now we will do the border also. Continue at the side, slowly draw parallel ones, the petals of a flower like. And simultaneously, you draw the base line also. So this is how you should complete the full sheet. I'll just show you. Is that clear to you all? You are able to see it clearly? Okay, now I have another finished piece on which I'm going to do the coloring. So this we will keep it aside, and then on a dried canvas, the painting or dried one, we will do the coloring. This is the finished one. Here I have the two fishes drawn freehanded, or the trace, as I said earlier, you can do. Then done the outline with the black acrylic color. Then we have, and then we have the flowers, half flowers, then the full flower, and then the border. Okay, the leaves, and then the fillers here and there. So like this, you have to complete the outline work. We will start with the coloring. Here the coloring is not direct application from the bottle. Instead, it is going to be diluted and then applied on the base. So for that, the colors which they normally use are only 7 in numbers, yellow, then they have orange, pink, blue, of course, for Ramayana, Mahabharata, they use blue. Then black, of course, goes without saying. And then red they have, then green. So yellow and orange, and then black for outline. For green, it is for leaf, it is green. Apart from that, they have pink also and blue also. So now using those, only those seven colors, you need to paint this, because we are, these are the recommended colors, and it is better not to use any other color, bring in any other color into this art form. So strictly follow these seven colors only. Now we will start with the lighter shade. Each and every lighter shade which you are applying on the base should be diluted first, and the darker shade for the shading part of it, the darker color for the shading part of it, there is no need for you to dilute it much. So only the lighter shade for the first coat, the base coat, you need to dilute. So here I will go with yellow first. Just see, take yellow color, transfer it onto a palette. Then to this, add few drops of water, make it diluted. Mix it well. No air bubble, of course. See to it you don't carry any air bubble in this. Now for the fish, I want to give yellow and orange combination. So what I do is, I will first fill up the fish with yellow. For that matter, you can go in for golden yellow or lemon yellow or chrome yellow, okay, because these are the regular colors which are available in the market, so you can go with those colors. And it is a canvas sheet, the base, so these acrylic colors works out very well. Now let me complete the body portion alone first, as light as possible. The paint should be little watery, not too thick. And while applying the color, in case if you happen to hide the black line, please do not worry about it. You can do the liner work later also, but as far as possible, please do not do like that. So try to pay concentration and then fill in the color. Okay. Now this side. Normally they do two colors at a point, yellow and a contrast of orange on it. But that contrast color we are not going to give right now. We will leave it to dry little bit and then apply on top, because we are not going to blend or shade or mix or anything of that. No technical work at all. Just application of the first coat, that is a lighter shade, and then leaving it to dry a little bit. Then you have to go with the second color, the darker shade. Now the main fish body portion is over. Now that this portion would have dried, so let me take orange. Once again, I'll load it on the palette. Here, the color, I will just add 1:1 ratio of water and then mix it, load the brush. Okay. Now the brush is loaded with orange color. Now, how do we do the shading? Not shading, actually filling up the darker shade. How do we do that? There is a technique, that is, you can't keep doing the applying the orange color all over, only around the border of the patch, whether it is a circle or a triangle or a rectangle, only the corners, the borders alone carry this darker shaded effect. So load the brush closer to the black line, keep the brush flat like this. See, wherever you see the black line on the fish like this, you apply this orange color. Here it is orange because the base is yellow. So to get a contrast, I'm using orange. Okay. Now you follow this black outline and start filling the, applying the color. Orange color. It may be different. On lighter green, you may give darker green also. Lighter blue, darker blue also. But here, as far as this fish is concerned, I have given yellow base with the orange outline border work. It is not shading, it is just the outline. We are giving the orange color. This is how they do in the original style of painting. Now let me complete the fish. Keep the brush flat like this and then you move it. Now over here, every now and then you load the brush for each stroke. Over here also. As far as the face is concerned, the fish is concerned, we are now done with the orange color. Okay. So this is how they do the painting. Now we move on to this portion. Here you have so many patches. What they do is they paint one of this patch with the color, leave the next one as it is. The third one, again the same color they repeat. Leave the fourth one as it is. Why do they leave it like that? Here and there on the base, they always have this base color seen in lots. Because towards the end, after they finished entire work, what they do is they just perforate it. Perforate in the sense they make holes. So they perforate it with a thick needle so that when a lampshade is made and when a light is fixed, the light emits. So to get a more enhanced look for the piece, they always make holes. And not only that, when they do it at night, enacting the story, telling the people the story through the puppets also will have holes in it and the light will be at the back of the screen. So when the light passes, the people on the other side will be able to see the character very clearly and they will understand the story also. So this perforation is a must. Border is a must and perforation is a must. Beginning border and ending is perforation. These two are a must for Tholu style of painting. All the other things, of course, they take here and there from Pattachitra, Madhubani and Kalamkari and then they do this work. Okay, now we will do, I'll tell you how to do this portion. Here what happens is, I told you, one will be the color, the other one will be the plain, the base. Let me go in with green color. Here for green color, they normally use the natural colors. So they always have sap green. Okay. So here also I'm using only sap green because these are the extracts they take from the leaves. So using that particular color, I'm going to paint over here. Now for the fish, on the fish, just color one portion with green, direct application, just 1:1 ratio. I have mixed the color, leave the second one, then color the third one with the same color. Don't change the color. Since you have started with green, continue with green. If you want to do red, continue with red. So it's like that. But since I have done yellow and orange, I don't want red. I want to complement the colors and have a good look. So I have gone in with green. Then leave the next one. So here I should pay my pranams to my guru, Mr. Sri Ramalu, from whom I learned this kind of art. Tholu Bommalatta style of painting. Now here for the leaf. Now this leaf has a different kind of painting. Here they don't give a base coat for the portion. Instead, only the sides alone they cover it. They just paint it with orange. Invariably only orange. Very rare they use green color for this kind of leaf. So here, see for this leaf. One second. Okay, now for this, I've loaded the brush with orange. I told you, invariably they colored this particular leaf with orange. Very rarely they give green color. Normally leaves are green, but here they go in with orange just to make it very, very bright, this outline towards the inner, not on the outer of the design. It is towards the inner, following the black line, they applied this orange. Okay. See this. See here. This one. This leaf I'm talking about, the oblong shaped. Only the orange is applied here. Sometimes they go with green also. They did. I have not given a base coat, diluted coat, and then on top of it any shading effect. Just directly on the canvas sheet, I have just applied orange around the towards the inner, following. Okay, now we will move on to this flower. For the flower, let me go in with pink color. So pink, of course, here you name it, you get it in the shop, so you can go with that particular color. Here for the flower, I have to dilute it, because just like the fish, I'm going to do the coloring over here for the flower also. So let me take little of pink on the palette, dilute it with water. Sometimes 1:2, sometimes 1:3, because depending upon the freshness of the color, you may have to add 1, 2, or 3 parts of water to it. If it is a little older paints, you may have to add 3 parts of water to 1 drop of paint. But if it is a fresh paint, on the other hand, just add 1:2. That is enough. Now here, this pink color, let me take and fill up petal by petal. Just see how light the color is. With a translucent color, they do it on the leather, I said, isn't it? So for the light to emit, they always use the lighter shade, just a thin coat of the color. So just to replicate that, here I have diluted the color and then applied the first base coat. Now here also, if you want to continue each and every petal, you can carry out the same color combination. Otherwise, you leave one plain and then carry out the same color combination. So that is one's own wish and creativity. Now, after this, let it set for some time. In the meantime, we will move on to this flower. Here, let me take yellow color. I told you again and again, they'll be using only these 7 colors. Of course, black goes without saying for the outline, I repeat. And the other colors are yellow, orange, pink, green, blue, and what else? The other one? Okay, blue and then little and darker, lighter blue and darker blue. Now here for this flower, just apply the color first, just like fish, how we did. Hope you are able to see. Okay, now I have applied green color. Okay, sorry, yellow color. Now I'm going to load the brush with orange for the border. Now the brush is loaded with orange. Now here on the yellow for the flower, just towards the tip, the coloring is done always towards the tip. So keep the brush flat like this, just a single stroke from one end to the other end. That's it. This is how they do. first the yellow, then the red orange on top. That is the orange towards the tip of the flower. Okay, now we will see this flower. Now this is almost towards drying. Now lighter pink I have given. The same pink, without diluting it, I am taking it in the brush. That color you apply here, like how we did for this flower, same way. And here also. Okay, now see this. Fine. Now we will do the border. For the border, you can go in for a bigger size number brush. Here also. One second, I'll just. Okay. Let me take yellow and pink. I'll have pink. Let me take little pink on the palette, then little yellow also. So both the colors are in the palette now. I'm diluting it. The yellow alone I'm diluting. Okay. Now you start from one end and move the brush and fill up the border, the full border, the petals. Just take a bigger number brush so that you can finish it faster also. And the work is neat and evenly spread the colors. Now once again, from this end, move the brush to the other end. Just make sure that the paint doesn't stand anywhere and it is spread evenly. Fine. Now the base coat is over. Now here, when you notice, now I didn't do in patches. The color was applied straight away from one end to the other end, even on the black line, which was already done. Okay. That is why I told you to make it little bolder and clear and with lovely black dark. Okay, so that now if you see, after even applying the yellow coat on top of the black lines, these lines are seen clearly. Moreover, the reason is we have diluted the color and the lines are prominent, jet dark, and then bold and clear. Okay, now we will do the shading. The application of the second color. Second one will be pink, I told you. So I have taken pink, and the for the flower or for the petal, the shading or the application should be always towards the tip of the petal. So just keep it here. Apply, drag the brush from one end to the other end. Just like this. Now you can start from this end also. Just see, I don't shade it at all. I just apply the color. This is how they do on the leather. The same technique is carried out, but with the acrylic color on the canvas sheet. Now just have a look at it. Looks like as if it's been shaded. Okay. Now this is how you should do the entire thing. Now for the stem you can give this thing a brown color. Now for the leaves here and there you can add light green and dark green. Some flowers can be light blue and dark blue also. We will do that also. So apply little we'll take little light blue first. Any lighter color for that matter should be diluted. Remember that. Okay, it should be 1:1 ratio or 1:2 or 1:3 depending upon the freshness of the color. So now I have taken blue color. This blue I would like to give over here for this flower. Once again, the lighter shade filling for the petal. Wait for it to dry a little bit to set, and then we will apply the dark blue color. Now for the dark, it can be cerulean blue or the Prussian blue or the ultramarine blue. You have it in the pack. Now here, just from one end to the other end, that's it. Now I think it's very clear to you all, this blue and pink, light pink with a darker pink on it, then yellow with orange and the base yellow with pink. Okay, now like this we have to do. Now the next step is, this is pure white in color, the canvas. On the other hand, the leather is little creamish, somewhat half white in color. So to get that effect, that kind of leather effect, you have to mix white, yellow and little brown. So take little white, little yellow, little brown. One second. I will just mix the color and I'll show you. Little white, then a drop of yellow and a drop of brown. Drop of yellow we can take from the palette itself. Just mix it, and this also should be diluted. Add few drops of water, dilute it thoroughly, then add little brown to it, very little of brown. Yes, we got the color, but this has to be diluted thoroughly. Okay, the more you dilute it, the perfect color you get. Now using a big size number brush, load the brush and start applying on the white portion, wherever you have this white portion. I'll just leave. Okay, just fill it up. Can you see the difference between the colored and the white canvas sheet portion? Since this is diluted, after it dries will give you a dull effect, that of a leather. So all over you need to do this. Okay, I'm just leaving the other unpainted portion just to show you. I'm painting on the plain canvas area where this work has to be carried out. Since the color is diluted, even if it touches the black line also, nothing happens. The black lines will be seen, because it's almost diluted to the maximum. Now this coloring is over. The base coloring is over. And just lift it and show. Fine. After this dries completely, you need to perforate it. What is perforation? We have to make holes on the plain surfaces of the base. Here it is the canvas sheet. On the other hand, they do it on the leather. Okay. So on this, you need to make perforations. I'll just show you the needle also. This kind of needle, we call it a skoni usi. So that needle you have to take the thicker one. Using this, you perforate on the plain canvas as well as on the white portion of the leaves, as well as on the lighter shades of the flower, then the petal, the fish, everywhere. The more number of holes you make, the light emits beautifully and your piece is too enhanced. Now here I'll just show you. Pass the needle like this, press it, take it, just prick it, make holes. I'm doing it on the white area. Like this. Now I'll just show you a finished piece. See here. This is the finished, fully finished one where the entire coloring is done. Okay, now we need to poke it. Now on the plain surfaces, I'm poking it. Similarly on the fish, here near the neck, we have plain canvas seam. There I'm poking it. Then the next one, green, white, green, white. And each white, I'm going to make holes. Like this you have to do. Now after that, after this is carried out, you need to varnish it. For varnishing, you can use the clear varnish or you can use Fevicryl Mod Podge. You have this also, a versatile product. This you can give on top of it. 2 to 3 coats completely on top of it. This varnishing or with the Mod Podge, after giving all this work only, you need to make holes on the sheet. Because if you make the holes earlier and then give a varnish coat, what happens is the holes get blocked. So please do not do that. Make the holes, give the varnish coat, leave it to dry completely, and then you prick it, make perforations. Okay, now after that, you make a small circle, a semicircle over here. This we are going to cut and convert it into a lampshade. Let us cut it. Or you can even fold it also and cut it so that it is evenly cut. Place them one on top of the other. You cut it. Okay, now we are done with this. Now the base is ready. Then you take the stapler, just fold it like this into a cone shaped. Then you staple it here. I'll just push the plain portion inside, bringing both the ends together. First you staple it and then you can apply glue and fix it. You can even give a padding also inside. Now just see, the lampshade is done. Okay, where to place and how to place? You have a this thing, ready-made stand available in the market, and then you can keep on top of it like this. Now, hope it is clear to you all. You can see this. Just see the lampshade, what we did today. Just see here. The two lampshades behind me are leather ones, and here this is the canvas sheet. Okay. Then we have, just give me 2 minutes, I'll clear up the area. I'll show you the other articles also, whatever I have done. Now, as the name goes, it is Tolu Bommalata. Okay. So Tolu leather and Bommalata is the puppet dance. So you all will be waiting to see the puppets. So I have two puppets. One is a 10-headed Ravan. The other one is the Ganesh. Now, this is what we did now in the class. Now, next one. Just a minute. You know. Fine. The next one is a wall panel. This is I told you, this is the Pakshi, which they have it in Madhubani style. So that Pakshi, I have done it here, and the border once again just like Madhubani as well as for Tolu style also. Okay, then the next one on a canvas sheet, just using two colors, rather one color I would say, because just maroon is used, the white and all is the base canvas sheet, and black of course we always use. So monochromatic, I have done one wall panel. Then we have a jewelry, the design which I shared you, once again done on the canvas sheet. And then attach the beads and other things. This is left to one's own creativity. So this is the jewelry pendant. This is about 6 centimeters in dia, this circular piece. And another one we have, another jewelry, again done on canvas sheet. Then we have the hat clip. I told you the accessories also we can do. So now this in close, the border pattern which I showed you is carried out in the center, and similarly on the other two sides towards the edges, the same border designs are carried out. A typical Tolu style of work done on a piece of canvas sheet and attached onto a hat clip. Then comes the tea coasters. Here again, this is the fish which we did. Since they are fish, I've given a blue background, and here on the white I have used only chrome yellow, nothing else, no other color is used. So I have tea coasters. You can make table mats and with coasters, a set of coasters. Then a paperweight on a wooden plank, a circular wooden plank, a paperweight, then a small door hanging, a fish, very, very colorful. Same here, when you see, I told you it's Madhubani, right? So they have this in between lines drawn. You just draw two parallel lines, and in between the two parallel lines, at equidistant, small, short lines are done. That is a typical Madhubani style of painting that is carried out here in Tolu style also. Then comes the wall hanging, an elephant, one below the other. I have three numbers. We call it as Yane Varum Munne, Pinne Mani Osei Varum Munne. So the elephant comes at the back and the ringing of the bell on the neck of the elephant is heard first. So we have three elephants here with a bell at the bottom making noise. So a lovely wall hanging, or you can call it even a door hanging. One number will go for a door, and if you have more than one attached to it, we can just take it to the wall. So just one second. So we take it to the wall. So these are some of the things, and the finally comes the 10-headed Ravan and the Ganesh puppet. I'll just show you. Here comes the 10-headed Ravan, the real puppet, Tolu puppet. This is how they attach the knot in this. The Ganesh I have attached. Just see here. The hands at the sides, one with the sword Ravan and the 10 heads. And look at the color combination. And look at the perforations for the light to emit. Just see the holes. Each and every patch has a hole. Even on the leather also, you just prick it with an ordinary needle. There is no need for you to heat it and then make holes. This is Ravan. Then we have Ganesh. For this Ganesh Chaturthi, let us celebrate with a Ganesh puppet done on the canvas sheet. This is how they tie the thread. And then they have the thread at the back. Like this. See here. Can you see the full picture? So these are some of the articles which we have I have made with the canvas only, except for that Ravan and for the two lamps at the back, the leather ones. So in today's session, I'm sure all of you would have enjoyed this kind of traditional art form of Andhra, Tholu Bommalata. Tholu means, once again, in Tamil also we call it as Tholu only. The outer skin, we call it Tholu. The same thing in Telugu also, they call it as Tholu. Number Thol, avanga Tholu. Okay, so Tholu Bommalata style of painting carried out on canvas sheet using the acrylic colors readily available in the market. Okay, now I just place everything. You can have a look, and any queries, we are almost nearing to the end of the session, and any queries you can just ask. And this is the one we did it now. Let me display everything. You can have a close look. A wall hanging. Then we have the door hanging. Coasters we have. Hair clips we have. And then pendant jewelry. Paperweight we have. So variety of articles. We have the jewelry. One second. See the jewelry, the clip we have. So something different all of you have learned today, and very easy to make also, especially fashion students. You can really rock with this kind of painting and with the accessories for your fashion show. I'm sure you would love to do this. And of course, the other participants, you can you have learned the art form. You can really earn out of this. You can make pieces like this. So I'll just keep one over here. and the elephant over here. And we have the lampshade which we made today. Okay. Now, is it clear to you all, or should I display it separately? Okay. Now let me do this. See, this is the wall panel. Okay. Then comes the other items. We have the coaster, the hat clip, the pendant, okay. So, dear participants, did you all enjoy? Ideas about making jewelry. You just take a canvas sheet, just like how we did the sketching on the canvas sheet for the lampshade. Same way you do it for the jewelry also. Trace out the design and then start working on it with the outline black. Then once the black is dried, you can apply the colors, the acrylic colors, and then give a varnish coat on top of it and fix it onto a mount board or on a thick, any other paper board like that. And then attach the other accessories as you wish. Anything else? So I feel so happy and honored to be with you all today in this live session. Being the first day, it is the Tholu Bommalatta style of painting on canvas we have done. And hope I am clear to you all with all the techniques. The same way what they do with the translucent color on the leather, we have done it with the acrylic colors on the canvas. Okay. And then this is the lampshade which we did today. Just see the flower. I told you the half flower, the technique first on semicircle and then another one, then the curves, then the yes, you can use this in the garment also. You can. That is what I said. The fashion students, please do it on your garment and have a fashion show of the Tholu Bommalatta style of painting. You can make apparels. On the leather also you can paint, because these are all acrylic colors. So you can really rock. You can do. Absolutely not an issue. If the topic is going to be, if the theme is going to be Tholu style, then you can really make wonders. See, the colors, only the recommend colors you have to use. It's always better. When you call it Tholu style of painting, only those colors are recommended. The colors are black, of course, first outline work. Then we have lighter color, the orange or the yellow. Then orange we have, green we have, blue, pink, and then what is the other color? Red. Sometimes we use red also for enhancing the entire picture. Anything else? So, dear participants, thank you all so much for your kind attention and staying with me till the end. And please do join me tomorrow also for the dress mural Kerala style of painting, the mural work we are going to do on a fabric. Get ready with the fabric and the designs also we have shared, the colors, brush, everything. Then we will... No, we don't do this painting on the mirror. We don't do. Then it becomes a glass painting. Normally when we do this, we use glass colors on the glass. But here it is only the acrylic colors. Though we can do apply acrylic colors on the glass also, but this kind of work normally they don't do on glass. Madhubani they do, Varli they do, all those Indian art forms they do. But so far nobody has done on glass. Anything else? See, other surfaces is once again canvas we can do, and then on a thick mount board you can do, pattern board you can do, art paper you can do thick ones, and fabric of course. Any other queries? Hope you all love the session, and tomorrow it's going to be much more interesting. You're going to learn the art of Kerala mural painting. These are acrylic colors. I'll just show you the bottle. These are the acrylic colors. You just name it, you get it. But we need only 7 colors for this to make wonders. And I told you these have a close resemblance to Pattachitra, right? So I'll just show you a piece where this is the elephant. See here, lighter blue, darker blue at the sides. At the back, I have stuck the eye sticks, then a fancy lace behind it to join them. This is also once again done on a canvas sheet. I'll show you the lampshade also with lot of perforations in it and a closer resemblance to Pattachitra. Just see here, this is Radha Krishna theme, a Pattachitra style of painting, but done on the leather using the Tholu style of work on it. So here normally in Pattachitra you have the side face, the side profile, okay. So that is adapted here in Tholu also. And then I told you the leaves. Those leaves are formed into flowers over here. Just the oblong shaped and then with the coloring. Just see this. This is the one I was talking about here, okay. Just see the leaves. And then see the face, side face, a typical Pattachitra. And then of course the border for this, and see the colors they have used, the same colors, nothing else, anything extra also they have not used. And then look at the holes. Each petal in this flower has a hole. Just imagine the number of holes I have made in this. This is my work, I have done it. Each and every petal has a hole. I have perforated all over because this has a light inside. So when I switch it on, the light emits. And this brown, of course, we hardly use, but in case we are doing a tree, we use brown. Yellow, orange, green, same thing. And even this Radha also, just the side face. Look at the jewelry, such a beautiful work. The Pattachitra, this thing designs have been adapted here for Tholu style of work. This does not have any origin as such original. So they have adapted from Madhubani, Pattachitra and Kalamkari. All the three put together, they have started this Tholu style of painting. And of course, the other epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata, they used to make different characters on the leather. So once again, I thank the management and other people, the dignitaries, for giving me this wonderful opportunity to get connected with you all today, tomorrow, and day after to share few Indian art forms in detail, of course, with the easily available materials. Hope you enjoyed the session. And we will meet tomorrow, same time. Stay tuned at 3 p.m. tomorrow, sharp. We will do a dress mural, Kerala mural style of painting.
Thank you, ma'am. It was a very creative and useful session for our participants. Now, moving on to with some questions for you from our participants, ma'am.
Yeah, please take.
So one participant has asked, on what other surfaces can we carry out this art, ma'am?
Okay. Okay. To begin with, this was done on leather. As you all know, it is Tholu Bommalata. Okay. Later on, people started commercializing. So we have started using it on canvas. Okay. That is recommended. Apart from that, apart from canvas, you can use some boards like this, thick boards, which is available in the market, stationery shops, or even the art materials, thick kind of thicker kind of boards, white boards you can use. And then you can use on fabrics too.
Okay. So one more participant has asked, for the elephant, should we add something behind for stiffness so it can stay for very longer time, ma'am?
Yes, you have to, because this is done on a canvas sheet. You have to add something at the back to make it stiff and stand so that you can hang it. So this is the front side, and at the back I have the eye sticks attached to it. On the other hand, you can cut a mount board like this, the same shape of an elephant, and fix it onto the back and add these laces for hanging purpose. Here the three elephants are added one below the other to form a door hanging, and each one is of a different color combination. When you watch it closely, this is on a lighter base, the darker shading towards the border, and here also on the back for the fabric on the back side of the this thing elephant, lighter blue first and then darker blue around the corner.
Then participant has asked, can you lit the light and show so they can see how the light goes through that small hall?
Just a minute, we will we'll fix it. In the meantime, you can ask me some other question.
So one more question is like, ma'am, in case more dilute acrylic color, it may spread in the fabric, right? So how can you actually do it without penetrating?
See, when you are doing it on the fabric, you should have a control over the brush as well as on the diluted paint. So if the color spreads, and first and foremost, when you start painting on a fabric, you just test the fabric whether the color, the water spreads. Add a drop of water on the fabric and see how much the water spreads. If it spreads very fast, then do not dilute much. If it doesn't spread much, then you can dilute it with 1:2 or 1:1, like that ratio. Make it diluted, the lighter shade of it. First you apply, wait for it to dry sometime, and then apply the next darker shade. So it all depends upon the fabric, how much it spreads. Anything else?
Okay, ma'am, leather itself, in leather, when you use it, you can use acrylic paints or any other paint?
On leather, on leather, we don't use acrylic paints, we use translucent colors.
So, is there any ethics to start this art, ma'am?
Like, I couldn't get you.
Is there any ethics to start this art? There means like in some art forms, there will be some ethics, right, to be followed.
It's not still, it's not clear. Can you repeat?
Is there any ethics to form this art form, ma'am?
Tolu. So there is the ethics in the sense we start with the border always first. And then we continue the composing of the other elements inside the picture on the base. Now it's here. Can you see? Just see the number of holes in it. I will just bring it closer. You can see the number of holes here, here, everywhere, all over you have holes. I'll just switch it off and show you the difference between the colors. Just see the color. Now again, I will switch on the light. Maybe through camera, it's like this, through mobile. But in real, it is beautiful.
Yes, ma'am, it was very beautiful to see. So thank you, ma'am. I hope all the doubts are being cleared. So the feedback link will be provided in the last day of the session. So now I would like to call upon our energetic leader, M. Mahmuda Begum, head of the Fashion Design Department, to propose the vote of thanks.
Good evening to one and all present here. On behalf of Dr. NJR Educational Research Institute, I take this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks to those who have directly and indirectly contributed to this three-day national level New Art Era workshop organized by our institute. A heartfelt thanks to our founder chancellor A.C. Shanmugam and the honorable president engineer A.C.S. Arun Kumar for accepting our request for conducting this program in a grand success. A special thanks to our vice president Dr. M.K. Padmanabhan, vice chancellor Dr. S. Geeta Lakshmi and our pro vice chancellor Dr. Ravichandra. We would also like to thank our eminent provost, Dr. G. Gopalakrishnan, our registrar, Dr. C. B. Palanivelu. A special thanks to our joint registrar, phase two, Dr. S. Ramalingam, Dean S. Manivannan, and Deputy Dean, Dr. V. N. Rajavarman, for their motivation and encouragement. A special thanks to energetic chief guest, Ms. J. Srinarayanan, for sharing her knowledge with our participants. Thank you so much, ma'am. I would like to thank all my team members, Ms. Kalaiwani, Ms. Nandini Kutty, and Mr. Ganesh Babu for their support for organizing this event. As we have come to the end of the session, I would like to thank all my participants for participating in this program. Kindly share your WhatsApp work on the WhatsApp group. Let us meet tomorrow for the day 2 session. Thank you.
I hope you all enjoyed this session. So let's meet tomorrow with an extraordinary day on Dress Mural. Till then, it's Nandini signing off.